ஸ்ரீ குருபியோ நமஹ. ஸோ இன் த லாஸ்ட் கிளாஸ் ஐ டாட் யூ த லிட்ரரி டிவைசஸ் ஆஃப் த போயம் கீப்பிங் குவைட். ஹோப் யூ ஹாவ் லேர்ன்ட் இட் அண்ட் மேட் அ நோட் ஆஃப் இட். இட் வில் பி ஹெல்ப்ஃபுல் ஃபார் யூ டு ஆன்சர் ஃபார் த இஆர்சி கொஷின்ஸ் அண்ட் த லிட்ரரி டிவைசஸ் வில் கேரி ஒன் மார்க் இன் எவ்ரி இஆர்சி. ஸோ யூ ஹாவ் டு நோ ஆல் த லிட்ரரி டிவைசஸ் இன் த போயிட்ரி. Now let us move on to the next lesson. All of us fear for something at one point of time in our life. It might be anything. For some people, cockroach is a fear. For some people, they have fear to fly by air. Some will fear for the snake. Some will fear to drive a car on the road. So the fear could be anything. It could be anything. But if you overcome the fear, after that you are going to succeed. Break the fear that comes in your mind when you think about one particular issue that you fear for. So break that. Have a plan how to break the fear. Long back there was an advertisement. I don't know whether it was Mountain Dew or Sprint, something like that. There was a caption in that. Dar ke aage jeet. So once you break the fear, it is going to be a success. That's what it said. So the lesson, what we are going to see today is Deep Water by William Douglas. In this essay, he gives an account of his fear when he was young that he had for swimming. And what steps, what plan he had taken to break the fear, what difficulties he has faced to overcome the fear, and how you are successful. That's what he says, a vivid description of the fear that he had for swimming. And step after step, how he overcame, that's what he gives an account in this essay. Let us get into the lesson. So Deep Water is the name of the lesson. So about the author, William Douglas was born in Maine, Minnesota, a western state of USA. After graduating with a Bachelor's of Arts in English and economics, he spent 2 years teaching high school in Yakima. However, he got tired of this and decided to pursue a legal career. He met Franklin D. Roosevelt at Yale and became an advisor and friend to the president. So you might be knowing Franklin D. Roosevelt was the president of USA. Douglas was a leading advocate of individual rights. He retired in 1975 with a term lasting 36 years and remains the longest serving justice in the history of the court. The following excerpt is taken from Of Men and Mountains by William O. Douglas. So it is a part of a book Of Men and Mountains by William Douglas. It reveals how, as a young boy, William Douglas nearly drowned in a swimming pool. In this essay, he talks about his fear of water and thereafter how he finally overcame it. Now, notice how the autobiographical part of the selection is used to support his discussion of fear. So in this, he talks about the fear and how to overcome. That's what he is discussing. And some of the words have been given, like treacherous, subdued my pride, flailed at the surface, fishing for landlocked salmon, misadventure, bobbed to the surface like a car, curtain of life fell, back and forth across the pole. All these words are expressed related to the essay. So we will check as it comes. We'll have these words and how it has been expressed in this text. Let us see. Now let us get into the lesson. It had happened when I was 10 or 11 years old. I had decided to learn to swim. There was a pool at the YMCA. YMCA is Young Men's Christian Association in Yakima that offered exactly the opportunity. So, in YMCA, they were offering to learn how to swim. They were offering to teach swimming. In Yakima, that offered exactly the opportunity. The Yakima River was treacherous. Treacherous. That means dangerous. Treacherous means dangerous. Mother continually warned against it and kept fresh in my mind the details of each drowning in the river. So as usual, like all the mothers, William Douglas' mother also warned him against the she warned against the dangers of the Yakima River, and she was giving details of the drownings in the river. But the YMCA pool was safe. So it was very safe. It was not treacherous like Yakima River. So I decided to learn in the YMCA pool. It was only 2 or 3 feet deep at the shallow end. So generally, if you had been to the swimming pool, you would have noticed one side would be shallow, the other side would be deep. So in the shallow side, it is for the learners, kids. 3 or 3.5 feet depth only will be there. The other side in deeper end, it would be 8 feet or 9 feet. So it was only 2 or 3 feet deep at the shallow end. And while it was 9 feet deep at the other, the drop was gradual. I got a pair of water wings. Water wings. Water wing is nothing but an inflated airbags will be fixed with the arm. Inflated airbags will be fixed with the arm so that it increases the buoyancy. The floating will be, you will float when you use this. It will help the swimmers to float on the water. And went to the pool. So he was 10 or 11 years old, so he went to the pool with that to have safety. I hated to walk. So he says that I hated to walk. I hated to walk naked into it and show my skinny legs. He did not want to walk into the water and show that he was very, very thin, and skinny legs he did not want to show. But I subdued my pride and did it. So He wanted to show that he is courageous enough, so he put up a brave face and wanted to learn swimming. That is why he walked into the pool by showing skinny legs. From the beginning, however, I had an aversion. Aversion, that means a strong dislike. Aversion means strong dislike to the water when I was in it. This started when I was 3 or 4 years old and father took me to the beach in California. So why he had a strong dislike? Because when he was 3 or 4 years old, his father took him to the beach in California. He and I stood together in the surf. Surf is nothing but mass foam will come along with the waves, and when it reaches shore, the foam breaks. So even we have, all of us, or most of us would have gone to the beach, we would have stood in the shore, and the waves come and the foam breaks just near our legs. So he and I stood together in the surf. I hung on to him, yet the waves knocked me down and swept over me. So the waves knocked him and he fell down. I was buried in water. He was buried in the water. My breath was gone. He could not breathe. He felt restless. I was frightened. Father laughed, but there was terror in my heart at the overpowering force of the waves. His father was there to support him, but the fear, the terror got stuck in his mind. It happened when he was 3 or 4 years old. Now he is 10 or 11 years old when he had given the account. So my introduction to the YMCA pool revived unpleasant memories and stirred childish fears. So when he had gone to YMCA swimming pool to learn swimming, the unpleasant memories of 3 or 4 year old boy came into his mind, and that aroused childish fears in him. But in a little while, I gathered confidence. But he just put aside the fears, and he gathered confidence. I paddled with my new water wings, watching the other boys and trying to learn by aping them. So I was looking at other boys with the water wings, how they were doing the same manner. He imitated them, he copied them, and he was trying to learn swimming. I did this 2 or 3 times on different days and was just beginning to feel at ease. So 2 times or 3 times every day he did. So because of that, he was able to feel, to some extent, it was comfortable. I was just beginning to feel at ease in the water when the misadventure happened. So this misadventure only he was talking about in his autobiography. So he says that, so when he was quite comfortable, 2 or 3 days he was doing, he was copying the other boys and trying to learn swimming. When he was at ease, this misadventure happened. I went to the pool when no one else was there. One day he goes to the pool when nobody was there. The place was quiet, the water was still, and the tiled bottom was as white and clean as a bathtub. So he's giving an account that when he went to the pool, there was nobody, the place was quiet. And he says that, I was timid about going in alone. So I sat on the side of the pool to wait for others. So he was sitting on the side of the pool and he wanted others to come and join with him. When others come, he would like to join with them. I was timid. He lacked confidence. Timid means lacking confidence. Lack of courage about going in alone. So I sat on the side of the pool to wait for others. I was waiting for others. I had not been there long when in came a big bruiser of a boy. Bruiser. Bruiser means you would have seen some of the students, they bully others always. They love to bully, they love to mock. So bruiser means bully. I had not been there long when in came a big bruiser of a boy, probably 18 years old. The boy was 18 years old. He had thick hair on his chest. He was a beautiful physical specimen with legs and arms that showed rippling muscles. Rippling means bulging. Bulging muscles, swelling, which shows that he is very strong. He yelled, called him loudly, "Hi, skinny, how would you like to be ducked? How would you like to be ducked?" Ducked means pushed inside. How would you like to be ducked? Now he says that he is going to pull him, push him into the water. With that, he picked me up and tossed me into the deep water. He didn't wait for answer. He just tossed this 10 or 11 year old boy into the water. That too in the deep end, not in the shallow end. So I landed in a sitting position, swallowed water and went at once to the bottom. So in a sitting position, he goes down underneath the water. He swallowed. As he was going down, he swallowed the water. I was frightened, but not that frightened out of my wits. He had senses. So he was having a plan in his mind as he was drowning. On the way down, I planned. When my feet hit the bottom, I would make a big jump, come to the surface, lie flat on it, and paddle to the edge of the pool. That is what he planned. So his plan was, as he touches the bottom of the pool, he would hit the bottom, bounce back, and he could, because of his bouncing back, he could make a jump, come to the water surface, lie flat on the water surface, and paddle to the edge of the pool. This is what his plan was. Let us see whether the plan works out or not. So, it seemed a long way down. Those 9 feet were more like 90. And before I touched bottom, my lungs were ready to burst. But when my feet hit bottom, I summoned all my strength and made what I thought was a great spring upwards. So, his plan was the moment he touches the bottom, he would come up. But the 9 feet was feeling like 90 feet for him. He was so restless. Before he could touch the bottom, his lungs were ready to burst. It was about to burst. So, when his feet touched the bottom, he gathered all the strength and thought he was going to make a great spring upwards. And he imagined, all these are his thoughts. Imagine, he would bob to the surface like a cork. You would have seen the cork. The cork, even if you put underneath the water, it will come up. And only half of the cork, the head alone will be shown out. So like that here, even if he's put underneath the water, he goes down. He wanted to bring his head alone out, like a cork. In a jiffy, he wanted to come back, but this did not happen. Instead, I came up slowly, he says. He did not come back like a cork. He is coming up very slowly. I opened my eyes and saw nothing but water. He says, I opened my eyes and saw only water, water everywhere. Water that had dirty yellow tinge. Tinge means trace, yellow color trace to it. I grew panicky. He had become very restless. He had become very restless to do anything. I reached up as if to grab a rope and my hands clutched only at water. So I was doing actions as he was swimming vigorously, violently. I was trying to hold something up, but he was able to hold only water.